we humans control inflammation and infection by using white blood cells. And those white blood cells have to kill infections and they have to control inflammation or swelling. Those cells are damaged in chronic granulomatous disease and they fail to make bleach. And bleach turns out to be really important for how you kill things and for how you control inflammation. When the white blood cell encounters a bacteria, it takes it inside and it puts it in a little container. Now you gotta kill it. How do you do that? You assemble a bunch of proteins on this container. They take a chemical in the cell called NADPH. They turn it into NADP+, because they've taken an electron from there and they give that electron to oxygen. That makes superoxide. And then that gets turned into hydrogen peroxide. And then that gets turned into bleach. And that bleach is involved in killing the bacteria that is inside the cell. In chronic granulomatous disease, people are missing one of these proteins, so they can't make the bleach. They have trouble killing the bacteria inside the cell. And chronic granulomatous disease is just like it says. It's chronic, goes on for a long time, and it's granulomatous. That is, they form little balls of inflammation in different parts of the body that can get people in trouble and make them have fevers or be very uncomfortable. Chronic granulomatous disease often shows up as recurrent infections, and those can start out as swellings in the neck or the armpit or the groin, as fevers, as diarrhea, as pneumonia, as abscesses in the liver or other parts of the body. There are about 40 people with chronic granulomatous disease born each year in the United States.
When I started as a young doctor, this disease was called fatal granulomatous disease of childhood because there was no treatment. And over the last 40 years, the treatment has grown from nothing to the use of immune stimulants, to the use of prophylactic antibiotics, to bone marrow transplantation, to looking into the future, gene therapy. People sometimes ask, why do you study patients with rare diseases when you're the National Institutes of Health? And the reasons are, first, that we give patients hope, but two, they serve as windows to understand some common diseases. Although patients with chronic granulomatous disease have problems with infection, these patients also have some reduced inflammation because the products that are missing, such as hydrogen peroxide and bleach, are very pro-inflammatory. We began to think maybe the enzyme that's abnormal in CGD could actually become a new target for a new drug to prevent inflammation in certain clinical settings in people who don't have CGD. And if we can do that, we'll demonstrate that you can take the journey from understanding a very rare disease to understanding certain diseases that are common and maybe coming up with a new drug to treat things that you never imagined you would be able to do.